What should Chinese President Xi know about your commitment to Taiwan?
We agree with what we signed on to a long time ago, and that there's a one-China policy, and Taiwan makes their own judgments about their independence. We are not moving, we're not encouraging their being independent. We're not, that's their decision.
But would U.S. forces defend the island?
Yes, if in fact there was an unprecedented attack.
So unlike Ukraine, to be clear, sir, U.S. forces, U.S. men and women, would defend Taiwan in the event of a Chinese invasion?
Yes. Ukraine, through the significant help we and our allies are giving them, and the incredible bravery and the incredible determination of the Ukrainian people, are not losing a war, and they're making gains in certain areas. Winning the war in Ukraine is to get Russia out of Ukraine completely and to recognize its sovereignty. They're defeating Russia. Russia's turning out not to be as competent and capable as many people thought they were going to be. But winning the war, the damage it's doing, and the citizens and the innocent people are being killed, it's awful hard to count that as win. His attacks on civilian, everything from civilian hospitals to you know, people's old age homes, to neighborhoods where just ordinary people live.
Schools.
And schools. It's just outrageous. And so the price Ukrainian people are paying for this war is extremely high. But we're going to stay with them as long as they need our help.
You're already north of $15 billion in terms of those commitments. How far do you go?
As long as it takes.